Hello there, I have a new mic. Greetings, Earthlings, how are you? Today I want to expand a bit more about metric modulation. I've talked about it in this video, but I wanted to dwell on it a bit more. And since I've just arrived in Israel, I'm gonna do it through a song by one of the best Israeli bands I know, Pinchas Ubanav. Or in the way less funny English version, Pinchas and Sons. This song is called Pashut, which means simple in Hebrew, which is funny because, yeah, it's not. Pinchas Ubanav is a musical collective led by Ofer Pinchas, a brilliant musician and composer I had the pleasure of collaborating with. They mix fusion and jazz together with a lot of folk, ethnic, and traditional music elements, all packaged with impeccable attention to detail, unique and engaging melodies, and great songwriting. And all this in a band with maybe 400 members, give or take. Okay, let's do it. We will be looking at this part, specifically the bass line. This bass line contains 20 notes. Not all of them are played, I'm obviously counting the gaps as well. These are the notes played. And this is how the riff sounds, including all the gaps. And here it is in tempo. In our musical context, 20 will be most commonly divided in two numbers, 4 or 5. This means we can group this bass line in two different ways and get two different versions of this bass line. And the differences between the groupings will directly correlate with the way it feels. Check it out. I'll organize these beats as 5 groups of 4. And I'll simply do it by just adding a click on every first note out of 4. We get a 5-4 with a 16-note subdivision. Now, I'll organize these same beats as 4 groups of 5. And I'll do that by adding a click on every first note out of 5. Now we get a 4-4 in quintuplets. And since we're dealing with music and the click track isn't necessarily the most musical of sounds, let's replace it with some drums. Notice, once again, how much influence the hi-hat has. The kick and snare stay constant. Or this version. A cool side note. If you look at this riff closely, and you see how it's organized melodically, it seems to kind of prefer the quintuplet side, because there's a low note every 5 notes, and this riff is naturally divided into 4 similar repetitions. So it can be very tempting to say that this version is more intuitive than this version. But we can't really forget about the familiarity level we have with these subdivisions. We, or at least me, and I'm sure that most of you guys as well, are more inclined to perceive music in 16 notes rather than quintuplets. And this bass line, the melodic aspect of it, kind of pulls us to the quintuplet side, while our rhythmic tendencies pull us to the other perspective. Anyway, the majority of the song is portrayed from the 5-4 in 16-note perspective. We do get a hint of the other side here at the end of the chorus that pulls us a bit towards the quintuplet feel, but very quickly we go back on track. Oh.
Same thing happens on the second chorus, same pull, but now we actually flip sides and go fully into the quintuplet feel. Okay, let's rewind a second.
Metric modulation is a change in pulse rate, so tempo, which is derived from a note value or a grouping heard before the change.
So in our case today, we're shifting from one tempo to another through a common subbeat pulse. And when you do that, you automatically change the tempo and the main pulse. The link between the two tempos is that shared subbeat pulse that is perceived as 16 notes in the first tempo and as quintuplets in the second tempo. But they are fundamentally the same speed. This is the key here. They are fundamentally the same speed and we choose to call them or refer to them by different names.
Once you do switch tempos, you have two choices. One, you can stick to the new interpretation of the previous pulse, which for us is now quintuplets. This provides a safe environment that helps both you and the listener kind of not lose touch with the previous main pulse. Or, number two, you can take full advantage of this new pulse that you got and go explore all these new subdivisions that you have. If you're planning to change tempo for good, you can and should actually take full advantage of this new pulse and root it as much as you can. But if you're just going on a short trip out of that tempo and coming back to the initial tempo, you might consider not strengthening this new pulse too much, because that will result in a very, very tough return to the initial tempo.
In this song, though the tempo does eventually change back, the section we're discussing does actually go all in with the new tempo by introducing subdivisions that are not the specific one we transferred to. So practically speaking, there are more than just quintuplets here. The change back to the original tempo happens quite quickly. The bass is playing this riff alone, which technically means we can still hear it in both ways. And Mr. Bass Player here does a great job not giving in to any side, but clearly feels it in the 5-4 version, as reflected by the band's entrance, and through his miraculous dance moves. By the way, you should follow this guy before he gets arrested or something, which will probably happen any day now. I highly recommend you listen to this band. This collective is so unique and for a very good reason. Great people and amazing musicianship. Thanks for watching.